Good morning, children. Let us continue with the chapter Unchanging Relations. Today, our topic is addition. Example 38 plus 25 plus 75. This we can do in two method. We add like 38 plus 25, that is equal to 63. Then to that number, we add the third number, 63 plus 75 is equal to 138. Here, we pair the number using the bracket to show the order of operation. We can also add like 38 plus 25 plus 75. Here, we add the last two numbers, 25 plus 75 is equal to 100. Then to that number, we add the first number, 100 plus 38 is equal to 138. So, in general, we can write it as, instead of adding to one number, two numbers one after another, we need only add their sums. In algebraic expression, we can express it as x plus y plus z is equal to x plus y plus z for all numbers x, y and z. Now, let's do some questions on page number 40.
First question is 49 plus 125 plus 75. To find the sum of three numbers, we have two methods. First method is that 49 plus 125 plus 75. Here, first we will find the sum of first two numbers. Okay? Then to that answer, we will add the third number. 49 plus 125 is equal to 174. Now to this answer 174, we will add the third number 75. Answer is 249. So answer is 249. Second method, same question, 49 plus 125 plus 75. Here we add the first two number. Here I am going to add the second two numbers. See, here we use the bracket to show the order of operation. First we will do the sum inside the bracket. So 125 plus 75. Answer is 200. Now to this answer 200, we add the first number 49. Answer is 249. In both the answers are same.
So, you can use any of these methods to find the sum of three numbers.
Next question is 1 by 4 plus 1 3 by 4 plus 2. Here, I am going to put the bracket over here because these two numbers are fractional numbers. So, let us add those numbers first. Okay. 1 by 4 plus 1 3 by 4. We can write it as 1 by 4 plus. This is a mixed fraction. Let us make this mixed fraction as improper fraction. How we will make? We will multiply the whole number with the denominator. Then that answer we will add to this number 3. Okay. 1 4s are 4. 4 plus 3, 7. 7 by 4. 7 by 4. The denominator will remain same. Okay. So 1 by 4 plus 7 by 4 plus 2. Okay, that is equal to 1 by 4 plus 7 by 4. Denominators are same. So, we write the denominator same and we'll add the numerator. 1 plus 7, 8. 8 by 4 plus 2. Now, 8 by 4, when we divide 8 by 4, we get the answer 2. 2 plus 2 is equal to 4. Answer is 4. Next question, 15.5 plus 0.25 plus 0.75. Here, I am going to put the bracket over here. First, we will do this, okay? 15.5 plus 0.5 plus 0.75. What is the answer? Let us add and see. 0.25 plus 0.75. 5 plus 5, 10. Okay, 7 plus 2, 9, 9 plus 1, 10. Put the dot. 0 plus 0, 0 plus 1, 1. So answer is 1. So we will write instead of 0.25 plus 0.75, we can write 1.00. Now we can add these two numbers. 15.5 plus 1. Answer is 16.5.
Okay. Next topic is addition and subtraction. Let's see an example. Unni had 500 rupees with him and gave 100 rupees to Appu. Sometimes later, Appu borrowed 50 rupees from him. Now, how much money does Unni have? That is, Unni had 500 rupees with him. He gave 100 rupees to Appu and then he gave 50 rupees to Appu. And we have to find how much is left with Unni. This we can write it as, after the loan to Appu, he had 500 minus 100, that is equal to 400 rupees. And after lending money to Appu, he had 400 minus 50, that is equal to 350 rupees. That is 500 minus 100. First we subtract what is given to Appu. Then from the answer we subtract 50. That is what is given to Appu. The same question we can write in another way. The total money he lent is 100 plus 50. That is equal to 150. That is what is given to Appu and what is given to Appu. So what he finally has is 500 minus 150. That is equal to 350 rupees. That is, first we add 100 plus 50. Then the answer we will subtract from 500. So, in general, we can write it as, instead of subtracting from one number, two numbers, one after another, we need only subtract the sum of these two numbers. In algebra, we can express it as, x minus y minus z is equal to x minus y plus z for all x, y and z. And the question, there are 38 children when the class started. 5 came in late. Sometime later, 3 went to attend math club meeting. How many are in the class now? Number of children in the beginning is equal to 38. When 5 more joined, 38 become 38 plus 5, that is equal to 43. When 3 children left, there were 43 minus 3, that is equal to 40. So this we can write it as 38 plus 5 minus 3 is equal to 40. Same question, we can write it as number of children in the beginning is equal to 38. 5 children came in and 3 left. So the final increase in the number is only 5 minus 3, that is equal to 2. So total number of children is equal to 38 plus 2, that is equal to 40. This we can write it as 38 plus 5 minus 3 is equal to 40. In algebraic expression, we can write this as x plus y minus z is equal to x plus y minus z for all x, y and z with y greater than z. Now let's see some questions on page number 42.
First question is 135 minus 73 minus 27. That means we have to subtract these two numbers one after another from 135. Instead of this, we can use what? 135 minus, we can add these two numbers and subtract together from this number. For here, according to this, what we have to do? We have to subtract this number from this. Again, from that answer, we have to subtract 27. Instead of doing that, what we can do? We can add these two numbers and subtract it from 135. So we can write it as 135 minus 73 plus 27. Okay, so 135 minus 73 plus 27, 100. That is equal to 135 minus 100 is 35. Answer is 35. Next question, 37 minus 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2. That means first we have to subtract this 1 by 2 from 37. Then from that answer, again we have to subtract 1 by 2. Instead of this, we can do what? We will add these two numbers. Okay, these two numbers we have to subtract from this. So what we will do? First we will add these two numbers and then subtract that answer from 37. Let's see. 37 minus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2. We see 37 minus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2. 37 minus 1 by 2. We can write it as 1 2's are 2. 2 plus 1, 3. 3 by 2 plus 1 by 2. Okay, then that is equal to 37 minus 3 plus 1, 4 by 2. Okay, that is equal to 37 minus 4 by 2. When we divide 4 by 2, we get the answer 2. Answer is 35. Clear? Next question is 298 plus 4.5 minus 3.5. So here what we have to do, we have to add these two numbers first. Then one is whole number, the other is decimal number. Then from that number, we have to again subtract this decimal number. So better what we have to do, we have to subtract this number from 4.5. That is better. Both the numbers are decimal number. So we can write this as 298 plus 4.5 minus 3.5. Okay. Answer is 298 plus 4.5 minus 3.5 is 1. So 298 plus 1 is 299.
Next topic is subtracting and adding. Instead of subtracting a number and then adding another, we need only subtract the difference of the second from the first. Example, 29 minus 17 plus 7 is equal to 29 minus 17 minus 7. Let's see the left hand side first. 29 minus 17 is equal to 12. Again, 12 plus 7 is equal to 19. Now, coming to the right hand side, 17 minus 7 is equal to 10. Then 29 minus 10 is equal to 19. So in algebra, we can express it as x minus y plus z is equal to x minus y minus z for all numbers x, y and z when y greater than z. Now let's see some questions on page number 43.
Next question is 135 minus 73 plus 23. Instead of doing this, here we have to subtract 73 from the number 135. Then to the answer we have to add 23. Instead of that, we are going to do like 135 minus these two numbers. We will subtract 73 minus 23. We will subtract 23 from 73. So 135 minus 73 minus 23 is 50. Then 135 minus 50. Answer is 85. Next question is 38 minus 8 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2. Here we can write this as 38 minus 8 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2. Okay. Here actually what we have to do is we have to subtract 8 1 by 2 from 38. Then to that number we have to add 1 by 2. So this we will write it as 38 minus
First, we will do this. 8, 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2. So, this we can write it as 38 minus 8, 1 by 2. We can write it as 8, 2s are 16. 16 plus 1, 17 by 2. Minus 1 by 2. Okay. Now, 38 minus, here it is subtraction, denominator is same, so we write the denominator same. 17 minus 1, numerator is 17 minus 1, answer is 16. So this we can write it as 38 minus 16 divided by 2 is 8, that is equal to 38 minus 8 is 30, answer is 30. Next question, 4.2 minus 3.2 minus 2.3. This we can write it as 4.2 minus 3.2 then plus 2.3. Okay. So answer is 4.2 minus 3.2. We can write it as 1 plus 2.3. Answer is 1 plus 2.3 is 3.3. Clear?